Hey guys, Andy here, and today on Andy Talks Japandy, I'm going to be answering the question for you, do I regret leaving Japan? Coming up. Alright, I'm recording. Hey gang, Andy here. Welcome to a brand new episode of Andy Talks Japandy. And today's video was inspired by a video response I did to Andrew Higgins of Higgins in Japan called Living in Japan, No Regrets. And I made that video response back in 2015 when I first returned to the States after having lived in Yokosuka, Japan for over 2 years. Today's video, I wanted to do something a little different. So I wanted to kind of twist that a little bit and answer the question, do I regret leaving Japan versus living in Japan? And in order to properly answer that question, we have to propose a what-if scenario. Had I got accepted to a university out in Japan versus stateside in Michigan? A lot of things would have changed had that happened. And had I known that I was able to even apply to universities and use my GI Bill money to universities outside of the States and still get paid BAH and all that kind of stuff, you know, obviously I would have applied to a university out in Japan, especially frickin' Tokyo. Had I done this while I was still living in Japan, I would have been able to physically go to the campuses out in Temple University and Lakeland University, being the two major English-speaking universities in Japan. And had I got accepted to one of those universities, the first thing that comes to mind that would have changed is that I wouldn't have bought my desktop computer, the Chillbox, because I love desktop computers, but they're not the most portable computer out there. The reason I got the desktop was because I knew living in America, first off, I would have the space, and second off, I wouldn't be needing to like move around as much. Had I been accepted to a university out in Japan, I would have gone for a more mobile solution. So I probably would have spent that money on a kick-ass like high-end laptop. The second thing that would have changed is that I would have had the far majority of my savings. Now, keep in mind, at the time, I'd saved up about $12,000 or $13,000. I spent a good amount of that money when I came back to the States on a car, and then the rest on living expenses, getting myself all set up in my apartment, basically carried me over for like the first 6 months. Had I got accepted to university out in Tokyo, I still would have come back to America in September to outprocess, as well as stay with the folks for 3 months until the spring semester started in 2016. But instead of moving out to Michigan, I would have instead just caught a flight out to Tokyo. On the surface, that sounds really good, right? Because I'd be in the country that I wanted to be in, and I wouldn't have to worry about Navy restrictions holding me back. I could continue making the Andy Japandy videos that I love to make. I would still be around my group of friends and still making videos, especially the videos I wanted to make, you know, with the Andy Japandy series and stuff like that, collaborating with people, all that fun stuff. So it sounds pretty good on the surface, right? But you also have to consider the negative aspects of that, and that is my transition out of the military mentally wasn't the greatest, and I went through a lot of processing emotions and just processing a lot of the shit, basically, that I went through during my time in the service, especially my time abroad in Japan. And I don't know if I would have been able to have taken it the same way as I did in the States. Things could have ended up a lot worse because if I didn't do so well grade-wise while in Japan, it would have affected my visa and I would have had to return back to the States if I failed out of the college that I went to. And from there, I don't know where my savings would have been at that point, and I don't know if I would have had a plan to fall back on had that happened. You had to take those into consideration as well as all the positives. And also, my mindset was a lot different at the time, you know? There's times where I go back and look at some of my older videos, and for this video, I went and looked back at videos from just like a year or two ago. You know, all these different experiences and all these different failures really helped mold my resolve in coming back to Japan. And I think had I just got accepted to a university outright, I don't know if my resolve would have been as strong, and I might have just kind of accepted my fate and might have just ended there. So looking back at all the failures that I went through, coming back to America, being accepted to a college out in Michigan, going through a lot of just adjustment issues, having low grades because of it, having to transfer to a community college to keep things going, and then eventually coming back to Ohio, stay with the folks for a little bit, to figure myself out, and then coming here to North Carolina, where I'm at now, going back to college, doing really well, I might add, and on the grind to come back to Japan. I don't know if my resolve would have been as strong as it is now had I just went to Japan right after getting out of the military. And also you have to consider freelancing, because the whole freelancing thing started when, you know, one of my friend's hard drives crashed. You may know him online as Tikyo Sam, my good old buddy, when his hard drive had crashed, and I decided to help him out, and it just kind of grew from there. Those are all what ifs and possibilities of things that are out of my control at this point. So the only thing I can really control is here and now. Taking all that into consideration and seeing where I am now versus where I was then, ultimately the answer to do I regret leaving Japan is no. While there are some things that I wish would have happened which would have made my life easier, the cons of the scenario and the potential consequences of that scenario being out in Japan versus stateside would have made things a lot worse and would have made my return to the country after being kicked out of school a lot more difficult. So I think all things considered, I made the right choice coming back to the States, and what happened happened, was what it was, but overall it's made me into a much stronger person with a much stronger resolve, and when I do make it back out to Japan, I'm gonna be a much better person for it and be able to make the videos that I wanna make and just have, you know, that drive. So question of the day, if you guys have lived abroad in another country and have gone back to your home country or to another country, do you have any regrets of leaving that country? And if so, let me know in the comments down below in the boopy boops. And even if you don't have any regrets, let me know. So with that said, guys, this is the Andy-san. Sign up for now. And as always, we'll see you next time. Catch you later, guys. Bye.